Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Latest Android, and in this tutorial I am going to show you how to move from one activity to another activity by an intent object. Okay, and you can pass different data, different strings or different category or actions from one intent, means one activity, to another activity by using the intent object. You are already learned about an activity concept, how it is loaded and how it is executed in your Android operating system. In the previous video I am already told you about such a type of concept, but in this video I am going to show you how to move from one activity to another activity by intent. So what is an intent? Intent is a class. You can use this concept by creating an object of a intent class and passing it to a method called start activity in your project. Okay, so by passing this intent object you can able to move from your current activity to another activity, or you can load different data to your intent object. Then I am going to say, or I am going to tell you, that an intent object basically contains different kinds of components. First one, action. What is action? Action is basically a path. Okay, that is a string type. Action is the path, that is string type of your activity, in which activity you'd like to move from your current activity. Then you should pass the path of that activity where you would like to move from your current activity. So that path name in which package your another activity is loaded, these path in forms of a string are called action. The second component, that is basically data. Data means what? You can pass different data from one activity to another activity by using the data component of an intent object. So these data components stores a data in URI format. Okay. Basically these URI format is already learned or should be learned by you if you already study about web application development. So then please go through this section, URL, URI concept, then you can able to learn about these things. By the way, there is no need to learn in this example, or in by creating a project I can show you how to create a URI object. Okay, next one, the next component, that is category. Category component is responsible for stores the information about your activity, means in which type of activity you are going to load in your Android application. There are different kinds of activity that you can load from your current activity. That means you can load a contact application activity, or you can load a web browser application activity, etc. So these types of activity which you are going to load in your application are known as categories. So these types of information are loaded by your category component of your intent object. And the next one, that is extras. Extras means what? By using this extras component of an intent object, you can pass different strings, or you can pass a bunch of strings by using a bundle object from one activity to another activity by using this intent component known as extras. Okay. And the next one, that is flags. Flags is responsible for, you can use flags component, this is not necessary, or you can use these different components. Okay. So this flags is responsible for to tell your Android OS that your current state of your activity, or you can set different states or different controls to your activity by using these flag components of your intent object. Okay. So let's start about an Android sample project where I am able to learn you about the intent concept. So I am name it as intent. Sorry, I want to choose this, locate this project in my folder Android Studio. I am browsing from here, home. Sorry my friends, home, Hajra, Android Studio projects. This is my location. I would like to choose this location. So activity pages, I'm name it is like this, next and finish. Let's see, now my main activity is finishes its build task here, and after building this project is opening. So I am already told you in the previous videos how to create a project. Okay, so now I am skip it, you can do it yourself. So let's skip it. My friends, my project is already building here, and now I am going to add here a relative layout. So just follow me, and I am going to tell about this layout or views etc. in the next video tutorial. So don't worry for that, just copy it from my video tutorial. Okay, so let's see, I would like to use a button here. Okay, so I am name it is ID. So that is not required, you can say that. And I am going to text this, I am going to set its caption or text, like suppose next. By clicking on this next, you can able to move on to your next activity. Okay, and I am going to add a method here. When you click on this, then onClick method is, or onClick event is fired, and then movePage method is called, which is located in your main activity.java. So that's why I am going to create this method movePage public void, suppose movePage, and you need to pass here the view object that is required, because this is a, sorry my friends, yes, because this is a view, because this is a method in onClick attribute of your view object. So basically this button, text, etc., these kinds of objects are commonly tell as views in our Android application. Okay, so now see my friends, this is my preview here. I am going to set is in the activity center. So and just use this Android layout center horizontal to, means it is positioned here as center layout. Now layout center vertical true, now it is positioned here in vertical position. So I am going to use here a text view. I would like to display a text here, suppose like this Android text. This is the first activity. I am going to use this text view so that you can understand that about its what is the activity it is in runtime. Okay, and I am going to set its layout center, sorry, horizontal true Android layout center vertical, sorry, this is not vertical, center margin. I am going to set its margin layout margin top, suppose 60 dp. here dp is commonly known as density pixel in Android. Okay, so don't worry for this. I am going to increase this text size here, so that's why I am just use here as Android text size, suppose 20 dp. now it looks better. Okay, so next friends, I am going to create another activity. So just click on this package. Under this package you need to create another activity. So just click on this and after that right click on it, and then you see that there is present different option. Just over in the new option and find the activity option, then under this activity option you find that empty activity. Just click on it, or you can choose different any kinds of activity. I would like to choose empty activity. Now my project is building here, sorry. You can choose different names here, like your activity name, you can choose here different name, but don't click on this launcher activity, because my current activity that is already I am designing here, it is a launcher activity. Okay, so don't click on this launcher activity. If you click on this launcher activity, then this activity is going to be the launcher activity. So when this Android application executes in your Android OS, then you see that these activities comes fast in your screen, and then these app, if you call this, then this activity can launch your Android screen. So I am going to finish this. My project is building here. I am skip this process here. Okay, next, my second activity is loaded here, and this is my second activity. See it here. As the first one, I am going to set its layout as a relative layout, and I am going to set its text view. Just I am copying it from this text view. just copying it, no matter what you done. Okay, and text is set and change its caption. So this is not the first activity. I'm going to change its caption as second activity. Okay, now see that here, this is the second activity. Okay, so let's see. In main activity, I am going to move this. When you click on this button, then this button under this on click event, this event fires the move page method. And in this move page method, you need to, or if you want to, I would like to move from this current activity, that is main activity, to the another activity, that is main two activity. So what should I do for this? You need to create an intent object I and just click on it. If you not import this, and just click on it and then press on the alt plus enter, then your package would be imported in this import section. Okay, so I would like to instantiate or initialize this intent object here by calling its constructor, and let's define its action by call the method setAction. So you action component should be setted here. You need to, or it is required to set an action component of your intent object, so that you can move from one activity to another activity. So I am set its action by calling the set action method, and I am just copying this path or package name of the second activity, and I am just paste it as string, and then your activity class name, that is my activity class name is main two activity. Okay, and after that you need to call this.startActivityMethod by passing this intent object. Now next, you need to open the manifest file, that is android manifest.xml. Here you see that different codes I am already told you in the previous video tutorial. Then when an activity loads, then this tag will be execute, activity. After that, intent filter tag will be execute, then action tag, then category tag. But when this activity is loaded, so here you need to responsibility, you need to serious that here when you use the set action method, this method is working if your action is already created in your, if your action is already created in your activity tag, under this activity tag, then this set action method change its path. Okay, but there is, you should be notice that there is no previous created action tag, that's why this set action method does not work. So then please create another intent filter, and please create a action here, that's why that action set action method can work, that is this action should be this, this is the action. Okay, just paste it from here and category would be default. See that here, my friends, when I already told you that why you are not to tick on that launcher I checkbox, because this main activity is already set as launcher. See that its category under this intent category component. See that its category is loaded as launcher, because when you click on this application, then this main activity would come to your screen faster, in fast time. Then if you need to, or if you want to change this activity, then you can change it by calling this start activity method with passing the intent object. So let's run our project. See my friends, my activity is running here and my Android application that I running from it is going to execute here. Then I would like to click on this next button, then see this is the second activity. Okay, so this is fine. If you like my videos, please like, comment and share please. And if you are new in my channel, then please click on the subscribe button, and you can also click on the bell icon, that's why you can get the latest notification from my channel. So thank you for watching my videos. Stay happy, stay cool, good luck.